So, in this chapter, magnetic properties, we will learn some basic question today. That was, why do you study magnetic properties? What is a magnetism? How do we measure magnetic properties? What are the atomic reasons for magnetism? How are magnetic material classified and material design for magnetic storage? So, those topics are addressed today. Okay, now those are the chapter outline. See here, the first question start. Why study the magnetic properties of materials? An understanding of magnetism that explain the permanent magnetic behavior of some material. Okay, that is why we have to learn magnetism, magnetic property. We have to learn iron and some other steel and the natural occurring mineral like lodestone. It is called another name magnetite, are well known example of material that exhibit magnetic properties. So this mineral is found in our earth and by default it is treated like a permanent magnet. Okay, now why study the magnetic property of material? There is some another reason. What are those? Many of our modern technology devices rely on magnetism and magnetic materials. Like electric power generators, there the magnetic use is enough extent. Transformers, they are also magnetism work. Electric motors, they are also magnetic work. Radio, television, telephone, computers, and components of sound and video reproduction system, everywhere without magnetism it should not be possible. Now see the magnetic field. Okay, magnetic pole, all magnetic material have two poles. One is a north pole, another is a south pole. Okay, just as in electrostatic, like ripples and opposite attract. Same thing in north pole, ripples with north pole, south pole ripples with south pole, but north pole attract with south pole. That means opposite pole are attracted and same pole are ripples. See here, north pole and it is south pole, it is attracted, but when the same pole are near about, those are exhibit some opposite directional force shown here with the arrow, it will ripple. Now magnetic field line, similar to the electric field line, the more closely spaced the line, the more intense the field. So how much close from the magnet the line is, more dense. That is why if you bring any magnetic material near about the magnet, then the attraction force is higher rather than the far away from the magnetic. Because of the same thing, the magnetic field strength is heavier to the nearer of a magnet. And another important point, magnetic field line point away from north pole and towards south pole. That means it will go start from the north pole and ended with south pole. And every line of action is closed loop. That means it is not like that north pole and not go to anywhere. No, nothing. If any line of magnet start from north pole, it should finish at south pole. Is it clear? Okay. See here. What I told. See, those dotted line are the line of action. Okay, every line of action start with north and finished at south. So when, see here, it is a south pole and it is a north pole, those pole are near about, and this magnetic line try to this north pole, which line is come to ended with the south pole, this line find the edge near here. So this line should go there rather go for the further south. That is why it attract. That is why the opposite pole attract. But here, the north same pole are aligned together, then it will ripple. In between, no line of force are there. So in that reason, the same pole are ripple and opposite pole are attract. It is a practical example of our magnetism when we did in our HS standard, may you did in your schools the experiment like that. When you bring a magnet in a table, if you thrown some iron dust, then this iron dust in school level, that if you keep a magnet in a table and if you throw some iron dust, then those iron dust shape like that way. Okay, every iron dust shape like that way. Now if you want to find the direction of this iron dust, because we do not understand which direction this iron dust is take place, then we have to use a small compass. Then if you place the compass, then we see here the needle is straight, then in upper side this needle is that line, then here, then here, then here. In that way we can see the direction of the every line of force. So it is a best example to understand the magnetic dipoles. Is it clear to you? Okay, Tausif, is it clear to you? Okay. If people meet Tausif from Saudi Arabia. Tausif, from which city you belong? A current loop and a bar magnet. So here, see the every line of action start from N and go down to S that way, and in that way the pole is generated, where the line of action, concentration of line of action much more, that point is called pole. See here, in north side there is a density of the magnetic line is much more rather than this place. That is why this place is called the pole. Same like in south direction also. So the magnetic field is same around in our earth also, because the sun, when the earth is rotated around a sun, there is a magnetism produced inside the earth, and we know there is a permanent magnet situated inside our earth. That is called the earth magnet. Okay, see here. The earth magnet, that this blue is our earth, and in between we can imagine this is a magnet situated in our earth. And it will create the direction of north pole and south pole like that way. And outside of earth, the magnetism, the magnetic line of force are created. It is our earth magnet. And it is called geomagnetism. Hello. You people get any echo of my voice rather than Renu? हेलो, नाउ इज इट इको? हेलो, ओके, 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 ओके देन. सी, दिस इज अ ज्योमेट्री, जियोमैग्नेटिज्म. व्हाट आई टोल्ड, द अर्थ प्रोड्यूस इट्स ओन मैग्नेटिक फील्ड व्हिच इज इंक्लाइंड एट an angle with 11.5 degree with the rotational axis. That is why Earth is creating an angle of rotation. The geographic north pole of the Earth is equally the south magnetic pole of the Earth is magnetic field. So same thing, like a magnet, there is a north pole situated here and the south pole situated here. Okay. Now magnetic field strength, we discussed about that in the previous class, what is a magnetic field strength. Now here some brief point about that. Created by a current through a coil, if you transfer a current from this end through this coil, okay, then what happen? The current will travel the entire length of the coil and it depend on the number of turns of the coil. Okay, the how many number of the turns of coil the current through this number of turns and finally get out from this air. Now question is the relation for the magnetic field strength, if we denote by H, the externally applied magnetic field and magnetic field strength. Here the magnetic field is generated by the means of cylindrical coil or solenoid consisting of n closely spaced term having a length L and carrying a current to a magnitude. So if you find the field strength, then the law is H is equal to NL by L. Here the n is the number of turn and L is the length of the coil and this I is the current. So in that way we can calculate the magnetic field strength H. Okay, is it clear? So if you increase the number of turn of a coil, so this numerator will increase, then the H will be increased. Okay, or if you reduce the length of the coil, then also the magnetic field is increased, strength is increased. Now, the field density, the magnetic induction or magnetic flux density denoted by the B represents the magnitude of the internal field strength within a substance that is subject to an H field. So, what is the field density? If you go for a certain place, suppose we flow a current through this coil, so it will create some magnetic field strength. Now if you calculate for that particular place that how many line of action go through this place, it will be our magnetic flux density. If we calculate in a particular area that how much line of action through that area, then it will be our flux density. That means how much flux is dense on that particular area, and it is calculated by, it is related by rather say, B is equal to mu H, where H is the, we know the field strength and mu is the permeability. Okay, now the permeability, what we will discuss later. This is not needed. Yeah, the magnetic field strength. Now the definition. Okay, the externally applied magnetic field, it is called magnetic field strength. Now magnetic induction or B or field strength, flux density, the magnitude of the internal field strength within a substance that is subject to an H field. That means it relate with the strength. The strength is increased, the flux will be increased and your B will be increased because B is equal to mu H. Okay, now magnetic permeability. The ratio between magnetic induction and magnetic field is called magnetic permeability. That means how much strain will produce the how much line of action, it is called permeability. See, if we go for that, that equation, we get mu is equal to what? Mu is equal to what? B by H. Am I right? Now we know B is equal to density, flux density, and H is equal to field strength. So that means how much field strength applied to get a field density. So this ratio is called magnetic permeability. Is it clear? Now some another definition is magnetization. It is denoted by capital M. The total magnetic moment per unit volume, it is called magnetization. And magnetic susceptibility, that is denoted by XM, the ratio between magnetization and the applied field, it is called magnetic susceptibility. Yeah, you may call susceptibility. Okay, M is equal to XMH. Now, measure the response of electrons to a magnetic field. See, electron produce a magnetic moment when we know that electron is rotate around its atom. Am I right? So when something rotating, then this element will produce some moment, and that is why the magnetism is produces. It is the basic law of producing magnet. When something rotating, then because of the spin, the magnetism is produced. गंदा ही तो जोल दे दो गंदा ओके सॉरी नाउ वी शुड नो द सम इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ टेम्परेचर ओवर द मैग्नेटिक बिहेवियर्स व्हाट आर दोस Temperature can also influence the magnetic characteristic of material. What type of? Rising the temperature of a solid result in increase in the magnitude of the thermal vibration of the atoms. And the situation of magnetization is a maximum at 0 degree zero K, at which the temperature, the thermal vibration are minimum. That means what? If we increase the temperature, the magnetism will decreases, because the magnetism will maximum at 0 K, and if you increase the temperature, the vibration will increase, and because of the vibration, magnetism will be decreases. Is it clear? Now, in that way, we get another interesting thing. What? With increasing temperature, the saturation magnetization diminishes gradually, and then appropriate drop to zero. So sometime what if we increasing temperature slowly, 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 slowly. So at the time arrive that the magnet reduce its loss is complete magnetism at a certain temperature. Yes or not? And that temperature we'll call Curie temperature. It is denoted by TC. At which temperature the magnet become lost its magnetism, it is called Curie temperature. It is clear? Okay. Now Curie temperatures for Fe, for iron it is 1043 Kelvin and in centigrade 770 degree centigrade. So if we heated a iron at 770 degree C, it will lose its magnetism. For nickel 354 centigrade. And for cobalt 1115 degree centigrade. Now the materials types can be divided into several main categories. So we have to know some different type of the magnetic material. Those are, this question is repeatedly come in exam, so make prepare yourself. Here this note you give clear idea about that, but you follow the book to know more. Okay, I just write one or two line for this making the note, because it will clear your idea, but for much you need the book. Ferromagnetism, ferrimagnetism, diamagnetism, paramagnetism and antiferromagnetism. Every year this question is come. May it come to describe this or it come to write your difference between ferro, ferri, dia, para and antiferro. So this question is very common. So prepare yourself, because in material science we have to target some chapter from where we get the number. We not go for the all chapters because it is your stocks. So we cannot leave magnetism, we cannot leave electricity, we cannot leave ceramic, we cannot leave polymer. Those four chapters for section B may bring you 40 out of 40. Is it clear? Because in material science our aim to get minimum pass mark, not get a A or H. Okay. It is a critical subject. So what is a ferromagnetism? A ferromagnetic material produces a magnetic field even in the absence of external magnetic field. What does it mean? It means that it is a permanent magnet. If we reduce the external magnetic field, then also this material is treated like a magnet. That means magnetic field. Sometimes we see if we use a coil for a solenoid, then it make a magnet. But when we stop the current flow between this coil, then it will not a magnet. It reduce the, it lost the magnetism. So in that case, it is not a ferromagnetic. But ferromagnetic which, if we remove the external magnetic field, that means it in case of current we leave the current, or in case of magnetism, suppose there is a permanent magnet and you keep a magnetic material here, in that case it treated like a magnet. This material treated like a magnet because of the higher magnetism, external magnetism. Now if we remove this and we feel we see that the small magnet, till that time also it is treated like a magnet, then it is called the ferromagnetism. Is it clear? And this magnetism will exist up to Curie temperature. Only certain material are ferromagnetic. Okay. Now see the ferromagnetism. The most important class of the magnetic material is the ferromagnetism. Magnetic material is ferromagnet are iron, nickel, cobalt and manganese are the example of ferromagnetism. Although the pure manganese is not a ferromagnetic, the name of that element shares a common root with magnetism, the Greek magnes, stone with a magnetite. Okay, not go for that, it is not a important. Important is that the iron, nickel, cobalt, these three element is perfect example of a ferromagnetism. Now, making a magnet from a ferromagnetic material. See, it is a ferromagnetic material. Suppose it is a ferromagnetic material, the first one, and see the direction of the magnetic material is not a shape in a same direction. It is horizontal, it is randomly placed in a atom. Now see, domain in which the magnetic fields of individual atom align. This alignment is not a same straight away. It is randomly aligned. The orientation of the magnetic field of the domain is random. See, no, not magnetic field. Because we know, if we want to get a magnetism, then the magnetic field, the align of the magnetic field, the orientation of the magnetic field should be a same alignment, then it will treat it as a magnet. So in that case, suppose the we take a iron and we find the all line of action is randomly placed, not a same orientation. Now we place a external stronger magnet beside of a iron, and see here, when an external magnet field is applied, the magnet field of the individual domain line up in the direction of the external field. This causes the external magnetic field to be enhanced. See, because of the external field, all the line of action between the material is lined up and it is converted to a magnet. Now, if you remove this permanent magnet from here, then we see if this line of action and orientation is keep permanent, then it is called ferromagnet. Is it clear? The orientation of this line is not changed after getting oriented, then it is called ferromagnet. Now, ferromagnetism. What is a ferromagnetism? Magnetic behavior obtained when ions in a material have their magnetic moment aligned in an anti-parallel arrangement such that the moment do not completely cancel out and a net magnetism remain even when there is a no applied force. See, in that case, what it told that magnetic behavior obtained when ions in a material have their magnetic moment aligned in an anti-parallel arrangement. Anti-parallel arrangement. What is this? We have to see that. Wait, I just show you. There is a chart. Here See, every line is line up with a external line up, same line up. Okay, that is why the strong. And what is a ferry magnet? I told you it is create a anti. That means, see, one atom is this direction, another atom is this direction, one atom is this direction, another atom this direction. In that way, it will create the ferry magnetism. Okay. The atoms having anti-parallel alignment magnetic moments. That is why it is called ferry magnetism. Now it is shown. Is it clear now? Okay. Now. Okay. Now move to our page. See, the magnetic behavior obtained when ions in a material have their magnetic moment aligned and anti-parallel alignment such that the moment do not completely cancel out and the magnetism remain even when there is a no applied field. That means if we move the external force but it remain in magnetism, not strong like a ferro, some magnetism is remain because of anti-alignment. Those are aligned but anti. That is why the magnetic force is very less and it is called ferry magnetism. Okay. See here the ferro and ferry magnets. They are in general oxide of irons. What are the example of ferry magnetism? They are in general oxide of iron combined with one or more and transition material such as manganese, nickel or zinc, that is MnFe2O3. It is an example of a ferry magnetism. Is it clear? Okay. Sorry. Now, diamagnetism. What is a diamagnetism? A diamagnetic material placed in a non-uniform magnetic field experiences a force toward smaller field. This repels the diamagnetic material and form a permanent magnet. Diamagnetism results from a change in electron orbital motion that are includes by a external field. The effect is extremely small and in opposition to the applied field. See, so then what is a diamagnetism? A diamagnetic material placed in a non-uniform magnetic field experiences a force towards smaller field. See here, it is a diamagnet. We know when we place a material, magnetic material, it will always attracted by dense area, bipole. But see here, it will repel out. It is a property of diamagnetism. That means always this material repelled by a magnet. A diamagnetism, magnetic material placed in a non-uniform magnetic field experience in a force towards smaller field. See, experience smaller field. These ripple the diamagnetic material फॉर्म ए परमानेंट मैग्नेट, ओके। डायमैग्नेटिज्म रिजल्ट फ्रॉम चेंज इन इलेक्ट्रॉन ऑर्बिट मोशन दैट आर इंड्यूस्ड बाय ए एक्सटर्नल फील्ड, द इफेक्ट इज एक्सट्रीमली स्मॉल एंड इन ऑपोजिशन टू द अप्लाइड फील्ड। इज इट क्लियर? Now paramagnetism. In paramagnetic material, each individual atom process a permanent magnetic moment, but due to thermal agitation, there is no average moment per atom. What does it mean? In a paramagnetic material, each individual atom possess a permanent magnetic moment, but due to thermal agitation, there is a no average moment per atom and m is zero. That means in between these, everyone treated like a permanent atom, but those atom are not aligned. That is why one is cancel out to other. Okay, not cancel, everyone cancel out. So that is why the overall moment of magnetism will be zero. So it is called paramagnetism. In the presence of an applied external field, individual magnetic moment take align along the applied field and it develops a magnetization in the direction of the external field. That means temporary magnet is an example of a paramagnetism. Now if you keep a permanent magnet over here, then these line of these magnetic material is aligned, and when this is aligned, then it treated like a magnet, okay, because the moment will be not zero then. So it is a example of paramagnet. Clear? See some example over here. Here, you see, for diamagnetic, if we not applied any magnetic force, it has no any magnetic material inside. But if you applied a magnetic force, the line of action created, okay, but not a aligned one. It is like a zigzag one. For paramagnetic, for non-present of magnetism, external magnet, it is not aligned. But when externally force is applied, it is aligned like that. It is, see, here the line of action is in reverse side. See here, external magnetic force applied in that way and the creating inside is that way. That is why diamagnet is ripple out, every time ripple out. Okay, but here see, it is created some magnetism, not a very strong. And same thing in ferrimagnetism also. Now antiferry. Arrangement of magnetic moment such that the magnetic moment of atoms or ions cancel out, causing zero net magnetism. That means what? That means what? Arrange of magnetic moment such that the zero magnetic moment of atoms or ions cancel out, causing zero net magnetism. That means the arrangement is like that, that way that the total magnetism is lost. Okay. Type of magnetism in solids such as manganese oxide, MnO, in which adjacent ion that behaves in a tiny magnet. Every ion behaves like a magnet, but as a whole, it is cancel out the magnetism because of the alignment, and it is called antiferromagnetic material. See here. दिस इज एंटी फेरो मैग्नेटिक मेटेरियल, द मोमेंट इज जीरो एंड आई सॉ आई गिव दिस वर्ड अगेन. नाउ एप्लीकेशन, द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ मैग्नेटिक मेटेरियल, व्हाट दिस अप्लाइड मेनली. द फेरोमैग्नेटिक मेटेरियल्स आर ऑफन यूज टू एनहेंस द मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स डेंसिटी प्रोड्यूस्ड व्हेन एन इलेक्ट्रिक करेंट इज पासेस थ्रू द मेटेरियल. एप्लीकेशन इंक्लूड कोर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेट्स, इलेक्ट्रिक मोटर्स, ट्रांसफॉर्मर, जेनरेटर्स एंड अदर इलेक्ट्रिक इक्विपमेंट. डेटा स्टोरेज मेटेरियल, मैग्नेटिक मेटेरियल आर यूज फॉर डेटा स्टोरेज. Permanent magnetic material are used to make strong permanent magnet. It is another use. Power, the strength of permanent magnet as expressed by maximum product of the inductance and magnetic field. See, magnetic storage we use, generally use, we hard disks we use. And earlier we may see in the video or VCR, there is a tape like that and floppy also, you may say, right? Tape like ribbon type tape rotating inside a cassette, and this cassette is a magnetic film. There will be some head, head is rotating and touching with the magnetic ribbon and play the video, or you may use the recording also. So in that way it is used. See here, if the current move from this direction to this direction, then the north pole is this side and south pole is this side. And if the current move through this one, then south pole is this side, north pole is this side. Is it clear? And if you keep any material beyond this, then this portion is create south pole, this portion will create north pole. In that case, this portion is create north pole, this portion is create south pole. So till now it is our structure today. Fine, is this material easy to you? Easy for you? That is why I take a time and make this study material, because in book there is a vast discussion about that, but I think you need some punchline, some hit that should remember. This note make you remember easily. You just refer this note and go with that book, then it will be easier to you to remember everything. Is it clear? Ha, everything I will send, yaar. No problem. And I also send the video too. I just make those video, but till now not uploaded. I just slowly uploading, and I will.